Hey guys, welcome back in CodeSphere. So today in this video, I will show you how you can store a checkbox value in Firebase Realtime Database. So as you can see on the screen, when I will choose this checkbox Monday and I will click on the button save, so you can see that there is a child created of name week, and inside this the day and the value is saved Monday. And when I will again uncheck this value and I will click on this, I will choose this Wednesday and I will click on the save button, so you can see that there is also a child created Wednesday. So today I will show you how you can implement this in your Android app. So without wasting time, let's start. So guys, for storing value of checkbox, single value of checkbox in Firebase database, what we have to do is simply create some checkboxes in your Android, in your activity underscore main.xml file. So as you can see that there are some sample checkboxes that I have created in my previous videos. So if you don't know how to create it, you can go and watch this. So for now, that it's time to go to MainActivity.java, and here simply first of all we have to create another class for our getter and setter methods. For this, simply click on new.com Firebase and then go to Java class, and we will give it name member and then click OK. So after giving it name, we will simply here declare a string, private string, and we will give it a name day. And then after this, we will create an empty constructor because it is required for Firebase Realtime Database. So how we can create it is simply write public and then class name member, and then so now empty constructor is created. So after this, simply click write and then go to generate, and then getter and setter methods, then control plus A, then enter. So guys, now our member.java class is created. So go back to mainactivity.java, and here we have to declare some variables for Firebase database, right, database and database reference. So reference, and then after this member, then this is for our class that we have created, and the last one is integer for incrementing data. Simply write I equals to 0. So why we are using it, I will explain it. So after this, inside on create, we will give it reference. So simply write database, simply write reference dot equals to database dot get instance dot get reference dot child. We will give it name week because we have to store day, and then after this we will write member equals to new member. Done. So I think now it's fine. And after this, so as you can see that this is the stuff of our previous tutorial in which we have created checkboxes. So in that video I am showing toast when the boxes are checked, but in this video we will store the value of that day which is checked. So for storing value, we have to first define some strings. So simply write string, we will give it name d1 equals to Monday. Then again string d2 equals to Tuesday, and then again string d3 equals to Wednesday, and then string d4 equals to Thursday, and then d5 equals to Friday, and then again string d6 equals to Saturday, and then string d7 the last one, and in this we will write Sunday. So guys, now we have defined all those strings. So after this, what we have to do is simply we need to write reference and dot add on add value event listener, then new, then value event listener. So guys, we are using this method here because as you can see that there is public void on data change on cancelled. So here you can show a toast that registration or storing value is failed inside this on cancelled, but it depends on you that what you want to do when the data is cancelled. But I will code inside this on data change. So here what will happen that whenever the user will store the value again and again, so it will increment. So how we can do this is simply use if then data snapshot. You can see this is our database changing variable data snapshot. After this data snapshot exists, so what does it mean that if the database, if there is any change in database, so this method will implement. So inside this we will simply write I equals to integer, integer, then data snapshot, dot get children count. So now this is complete. That's all we have to do inside this. And now come inside button, and here this is our button, and this is set on click listener method. So it calls whenever the button is clicked. So inside this, what we will write is simply member dot set day d1. So when the Monday, whenever this Monday checkbox is checked, then what it will do, it will save the value d1, and you can see that d1 is our string, its value is Monday. So whenever the Monday box is checked, then it will save that value in database. And after this we will write reference dot child and then string and then dot value of I. It is an integer value that we have defined, and I plus 1, and then after this set value member. So is now what will happen that whenever the Monday box is checked, then it will save the value d1 the Monday. And when the user will change the data, when they will store that value again and again, so it will increment it. As you can see that here we are declaring it string dot value of I plus 1. So what we have to do is simply copy this code and then go inside this. You can see I have commented the toast section, so we have to simply need to change it to d2, and then again inside this we have to paste this line, and here we will change it to d3. So and inside this again we will paste this line, control plus v, and we will do this d4. So in this tutorial we are talking about storing a single value, and if you want to store multiple values, so let me know in comment section. I will also make a video on this, that how you can store multiple values. I have to make here d5, and again inside this control plus v, and then d6, and this is the last one. So control plus v, and change here its value to d7. So as now our coding part is almost complete. We have created our member.java, and we have given reference, and now I think everything is fine. And before running your app, make sure you give the internet permission in your manifest file. If you will not give it, then the data will not store in real-time database. So now it's time to run Android app and see what will happen. I am running it in my virtual emulator and open Firebase database. As you can see that this is real-time database, and I think my Wi-Fi have some problem. Let me check this. So now it will be fine. Yes, so now what is it, let me run this again because my Wi-Fi stopped working. So guys, now you can see that our app is running, and hopefully there should be no error. And yes, there is no error. So now it's time to check that is it working or not. So if I will check this Monday and click on this button save btn, so you can see that there is a child created of name week that we have given inside our Android app, and there is first child and its name is Monday. So why we have used that integer, that if I will uncheck this one, and when I will check this again and I will click save, you can see that the data is incremented, it is not overrided. And if I will uncheck this Monday and I will check Friday, and again I will click on save, so you can see that child is incremented and the day is Friday. So if you will uncheck, so in this tutorial I'm only storing single checkbox value. If you want to store multiple checkboxes value, then Let me know in comment section. I will make another video on this, so you can see that day is Sunday. So this was the quick tutorial. Not a quick tutorial, it is a little bit lengthy, but it's fine. So this was a tutorial of how you can store checkbox value in Firebase Realtime Database with auto increment. So in case if you like this video, then please like, share and subscribe my channel for future tutorials, because and don't forget to press the bell icon, because I will upload more interesting videos like this. Thank you for watching.